But first, airlines are working to clear the extensive backlog of passengers now that flights grounded by the volcanic ash cloud have resumed.
We'll get the latest from airports here in Sydney, in Melbourne and in Wellington, New Zealand. But first to Tens, Ellie Southwood at the domestic terminal. Ellie, how long is it going to take for the schedules to get back to normal?
Oh, Deb, the airlines say it's just too early to tell, but I can tell you that as we go to air tonight, all the carriers are scrambling to put on extra flights and find bigger planes to try and clear this backlog of tens of thousands of passengers. Of the domestic carriers, Virgin has flown the most in and out of Melbourne today. Qantas and Jetstar resumed their services after lunch, and just in the last few minutes, Tiger 2 has resumed its services to Melbourne.
Finally up in the air. After hours of delays and hundreds of flight cancellations, the southern skies are once again open for business. The first carrier to take off this morning, Virgin Australia, much to the relief of its stranded passengers.
Obviously, to do so, we made sure that, you know, everything was 100% safe, and we believe that it is 100% safe to fly now.
Virgin planes used more fuel by flying lower and going around the plume. Qantas, Jetstar and Tiger weren't prepared to do the same.
Our policy is very clear. Qantas will not fly under the ash cloud. Qantas will not fly around the ash cloud.
They're an ultra-conservative company, And for many, many people, that's just the way they'd like them to be.
Qantas and Jetstar didn't resume Melbourne services until after 1 p.m. That's 6 hours after Virgin.
So it's different policies, different airlines. Doesn't mean that one's safe and one's unsafe. It's just a different way they look at this situation.
This is where the ash is coming from. The Cordoncalier volcano in Chile, which erupted 9 days ago. From space, these NASA pictures show the ash cloud drifting east, full of tiny particles of rock and glass that could shut down an aircraft engine. All up, Qantas cancelled over 100 flights, including 3 international routes. Jetstar cancelled more than 80. Virgin suspended 20 flights this morning. And Tiger has a backlog of at least 40. Qantas and Jetstar flights to New Zealand and Tasmania remained grounded for now.
This will take some time. There are 20,000 Qantas passengers who have been impacted by these flights. This is obviously a significant backlog.
And the delays may continue. The volcano is continuing to erupt.
Now, the latest information from the Bureau is that the ash cloud is becoming thinner and moving higher and will clear over Melbourne over the next 12 hours. It will take a little bit longer to clear from Tasmania, about 24 hours. It's not expected to reach us here in Sydney because of the low that's sitting over us at the moment, but it is expected to cause problems for flights in and out of Adelaide and Canberra in coming days. There's also the possibility that a second cloud will move over the southeast parts of Australia in the next 72 hours, but it's not expected to have the same impact, and it may just end up over Antarctica. Now, all this, as you can imagine, has caused huge frustrations for passengers. We've heard stories of some paying $1,200 for a taxi from Melbourne to Sydney. Tens' Ashley Brown has spent her day speaking with affected passengers. Here's her report.
Families are being kept apart and it's starting to take its toll.
Not real good. We're going home to see the family. So I don't know when we'll get there now, so.
Jodie Hogan is a single mum stranded 1,400 kilometres away from her two sons in Tasmania.
Very hard. I want my boys. I miss my kids.
While families stranded together are paying a high price.
It's really difficult. We have to get up, make sure the kids have their food, make sure that we have everything packed. It's expensive here in Sydney.
Across the Tasman, footy stars are lapping up yesterday's victory, but not the delays. The West Tigers are stranded in Auckland, along with Aussie netballers. The backlog will take days to clear. Most passengers are understanding.
The volcano ashes came out of the volcano, but we wanted to go to Melbourne.
Look, I'd prefer to be in Melbourne tomorrow than down on the ground dead. So it's better to be safe than sorry, I guess.
Some Tasmania-bound travellers can't fly home until Sunday. Hire cars are scarce and trains to and from Melbourne are filling up fast, even with extra carriages to cope with demand.
To add to the inconvenience, many passengers have been forced to come to the airport to rebook their flight because phone lines have been jammed.
Fortunately, getting through to loved ones has been much easier.
I love yous heaps and I'll see you soon and I'll get you a prezi each.
Ashley Brown, 10 News.
And 10's Candice Wyatt joins us from Melbourne Airport. Candice, what's the backlog like there?
Well, slowly but surely, the airlines here in Melbourne are starting to clear the backlog. Virgin was the first to resume its flights from 7 o'clock this morning, and it did so by flying at a lower altitude to avoid that volcanic ash cloud. Now, by the time Qantas resumed its flights at 1 o'clock, the airport here was packed to the brim. And when it did resume, it did so by staggering its flights. It started with just three, one to Brisbane, one to Adelaide, and a Jetstar flight to Maroochydore. Now, as we speak, Tiger Airways is the last of the major airlines to resume its flights from 5 o'clock this evening. It has its planes back up in the air. It says, though, that it's in the fortunate position of having a much smaller backlog because it's been offering its customers refunds today to allow them to make alternative travel arrangements. It does say, though, that it will accommodate people who are trying to get onto planes, but it will be a case of first in, best dressed. And if you'd like to talk about goodwill, then the RAAF just had a flight leave from Hobart this afternoon. It was carrying Tasmania's federal politicians bound for Canberra for the resumption of Parliament.
Thank you. Candice White there in Melbourne.
And for the latest from across the Tasman, let's go to TVNZ reporter Matt McLean. Matt, how are the airlines coping there?
Yes, well, good evening. Take a look behind me. Some very empty Jetstar and Qantas check-in counters. They've been like this all day after the airline suspended its domestic services yesterday. They've continued that through to today. Currently, the ash cloud in New Zealand is sitting at about 27,000 feet. Airlines usually fly at about 30,000, and the Qantas group says it's their policy not to fly anywhere below that, which is why they've cancelled their services. But that's frustrating many Jetstar and Qantas passengers here in New Zealand, especially after other airlines like Air New Zealand are continuing their services today. They've told me of their frustration. Many have had to spend hundreds of dollars to book new flights. It's important to note that the airlines will be continuing to monitor this very changing situation. There's no guarantee that we won't get any more ash over from that volcano in Chile, which continues to erupt. So airlines are telling domestic passengers here in New Zealand just to monitor the situation on the websites and phone them up if they've got any concerns about their flights over the coming days.
Thank you. Matt McLean in Wellington.